Van Dyke, who just recently won all those awards in the Emmy show, of course, first started in radio, which a lot of people don't realize. Where was that, Dick, that you started in radio?
Danville, Illinois.
Yeah.
There was a CBS station there.
And what sort of a radio show did you do?
I played records.
Did you do Kidding Around?
No. I wasn't too good at that, Bob.
I played
records and read commercials and did the news every hour, and that was it. You know, 250 watts, I was the only guy there. There was nobody else in the whole station.
Did you have long stretches where you're just all by yourself, really?
Yeah. And it was in a hotel downstairs, and right across the hall was the bar and grill of the hotel. And drunks were always wandering into the newsroom, you know, as I was taking things off the ticker tape. Where's the men's room? On the air, you know.
They would do this while you're on the air?
Oh, yeah. Isn't that funny?
Don't cry. I mean, don't feel bad. But you have had a succession of
failures. Right. Yes, I have a long list of failures.
Well, how did Carl Weiner ever take the chance on putting you in a series?
I don't know. I really don't know.
There might be another way of saying that. The truth of the matter is I can say this because Dick is a success now. It would be a terrible thing if he weren't, you know, and then to say, how did you ever end up in a show? But Carl Weiner had done your show originally as a pilot, right?
That's right, and played it in himself. Played my part. It was a little bit different show, but it was, you know, basically the same thing.
Yeah.
And I don't know why that didn't sell, the kind of performer Carl is.
You also did Bye Bye Birdie on Broadway.
Yeah, that's right.
How did that come about? How did you get into a Broadway show?
I just went in there and auditioned. And I went in and sang a dance. I did Once in Love with Amy and did a little soft shoe. And I got the job.
Really?
Yeah.
Now, one of the few things that happens in this town when they get around to doing the movie of Bye Bye Birdie, they hired you to do that, too.
Yeah, I understand they tested everybody else in town first, though.
No, they did
with Robert Preston, a music man. Just because he did it well on Broadway didn't convince them.
Yeah.
So they tried everybody else out and finally came back to Preston. But I went in and screen tested for Bye Bye Birdie.
Didn't they just screen test?
Yeah, I did Once in Love with Amy.
Oh, dear. 17 minutes before 9. We'll get back to Dick.